Can I make dua after my salah? I heard you say that one should make it only during the salah, but I feel like I can take my time after the salah and I have conversation with Allah in my own language. I like the way you presented your question, and thank you so much. Yes, indeed, I quoted a few ahadith indicating that the best time to make dua is in the prayer and while in sujood. And this is what the Prophet ﷺ said, because he mentioned that when you prostrate yourself before Allah and you place your forehead and nose against the floor or the janamaz or whatever, and you say, Ya Rabb, Allah likes you to say, Oh my Lord, and ask from Him, and He's willing to give you as much as you want. Okay, and answer your dua. You are the closest to Him whenever you are in this position. And I also mentioned that the Prophet ﷺ used to make dua after reciting the Durood Sharif at tashahud, in the last part of the prayer, and before making taslim. I quoted some prescribed supplications, such as seeking refuge with Allah against the four trials, life and death, the trial of life and death, the trial of the torment of the grave, and the trial of the false Messiah. And then the Prophet ﷺ used to seek forgiveness for all the sins. Allahumma اغفر لي ما قدمت وما أخرت وما أسررت وما أعلنت وما أنت أعلم به مني أنت المقدم وأنت المؤخر لا إله إلا أنت. What about after the prayer? You know, the brother or the sister says, I like to converse with Allah in my own language after the prayer. No problem. You can do it. The issue is, whenever people consider making dua after the prayer as an inseparable tradition from the prayer, like khitam al-salah, for instance. So you find in some masajid, people make khitam al-salah out loud together, make the adhkar, recite the adhkar together, then they make dua in congregation. Then we say, look, we all truly love Allah, and we love His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And no doubt that if this practice was recommended, was advised, or liked by Allah, it would have been prescribed. No way that the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, could have neglected it, or knew about it and did not inform us about it, or did not even know about it entirely, because it doesn't fit. It doesn't fit him as a prophet. So I would like to stick to what the Prophet ﷺ used to do. He used to recite Ayat al-Kursi, make tasbih, tahmid, takbir 33 times each. Recite al-mu'awwidhat each surah once, except after Maghrib and Isha. There is extra adhkar, and we recite al-mu'awwidhat, the set 3 times. Fine, just do that. I would like to make dua. Make dua. But it is not something to be done on constant basis or as a requirement after every prayer. Basically, you can definitely make dua anytime you want, even in a state of major impurity, because this is not reciting the Quran. You can make dua anytime you want.